Today we're going to be talking about our new web app for PowerChurch Online users that allows access to your PowerChurch data from a smartphone or a mobile device. You can actually also access your data through a web browser. That is because this is actually not a native app that is installed, but actually a what we consider a web app, which is mostly just a website. So let's take a look at it. To get to the app, you simply go to the page m.mypowerchurch.com, and it'll bring you to the logon screen. Now, if you would like to have a homepage icon on your mobile device, you can do that by clicking this button and then add to home screen. Give it a name and then click add. And you can actually see I've already have one here, but this is our new one. It works just like that. To log in, you're going to use your IDS client logon, which will go here. That's your PCU number. You'll use your PowerChurch username that you use when you actually go in to log into PowerChurch. That will go here. And this password is the one correlated with your PowerChurch username. So if you're logging in as system admin into PowerChurch, you'll use the correlating password here. For the demo today, I'm just going to log in as demo1. And this username and password, if you'd like to check out the web app, does work for you to do such. Demo1, and the password is demo. Okay, here you can see the web app. This is the basic layout of it. For the moment, the web app is including data from the membership module. That's going to include family mailing list, personal profiles, activity lookup, and there will also be visitation information that you can access through these menus. Before we get into any of that, you can also see there's some searches here. You can do different name searches, phone numbers, and email searches. But we'll start right here where the preferences are, because there's some powerful tools in here that will help you navigate this web app very efficiently. So there's several different categories. Most of these areas pertain to the family mailing list, these three in particular. This general tab is going to have a default who visits. We'll get to a little bit more of this a little later on, but you can add visitation information through the mobile app. This general button is going to set who sets those visitations. So if you are Jones P and you're visiting a family and you're trying to record your visitation, it will automatically assign it to Jones P. There's some other things in here, like the mailing category. If you're only wanting to see information, for example, of your families who are marked as members, you can uncheck all these boxes like this, and now the only results that you'll get when you do searches and when you look people up are your members. For now, we'll just leave that as select all. Another great area is if you use the personal status codes, you can do the same thing. This is looking for individuals, so if you only wanted to see children, again, you can uncheck all these other boxes down through here and only get results for the children. For now, we'll go ahead and leave that selected all as well. Also, a really cool feature is this activity sort. This is really handy, especially if you're pertain to one area of the church or the other. For example, a youth pastor or a children's pastor could go through here and uncheck all the adult activities and just have the children activities. Of course, you'd have to go all the way down through here. And then you're only going to get results for the kids that are in your classes. So that's a neat way to filter through the results. For now, we'll just leave it as select all. Clicking update will save you and bring you back to this screen. So let's kind of get into our data now. We'll start here with the family lookup. And as you can see, it shows us all the names of a family in our demo data, which isn't a very large list. Hopefully your list will be much longer. This is just some sample data. The first thing I would like to point out is this navigate and the group by features. The navigate button will allow you to move around the web app much quicker than using the back button. So you can see we can go back to our home page or we could go directly to an email search or a phone search or whatever you need to go. The other thing that was on here is the group by. There are several different sort options on these screens. So you could sort by categories. So this would be your mailing category. If you click that, you can see that the screen changed here, and now we can look at regular attenders instead of just members, or members, which there should be more than regular attenders or visitors. Okay, so that's another way to kind of sort things out so that you can kind of get around quicker. So let's actually go in and look at one of these families here. We'll pick on Alan Cunningham here. Here's the main page that we have, and as you can see, it actually has quite a bit of information here. I'll just show it to you real quickly, and then we'll kind of break it down a little bit. So you can see all the contacts. You can see the members of the family. These pictures are pulled from the personal profile, so if you have pictures in that area of your PowerChurch, they will show up here. And then, of course, visitations down here at the bottom. So let's just give you a quick breakdown. The first thing I'd like to point out is this edit button. This data set is actually editable. So if you click on this paper and this pencil here, you can actually go in and edit the data. So if we find that we're in the wrong zip code, for example, that was meant to be a 4 instead of a 6, you can go ahead and make that change and save it. And you'll see the results. I actually need to change that back because I need to show you the map feature. The map feature is actually very handy if you're on your smartphone and you're out trying to visit the Alan Cunningham family or any other member. You can actually get directions directly to your smartphone. Okay, so here on the main page, you see the address, and then there's this button right here. It looks kind of like a map. If you click on it, it will actually bring up Google Maps here and show you where it is that you're trying to go. And of course, from here, you can fill out the rest of the information to get directions from the Google Maps app. So that's a very handy feature. Also, if you're on a smartphone, you can click on the phone number, and that will actually bring up the phone dollar for you, so you can actually make the phone call directly from here. This is a really nice feature that keeps you from having to update all of your phone contacts with your entire membership. You can just log into the web app and dial directly from here. Same thing works with the email. If you click on the email, it'll bring up your native email client and allow you to fill out an email and send it on. Okay. And you can click on any one of these. We're in the family members section now. You can click on any one of these names and pictures, and it'll take you to the individual information. We'll get to some of that in just a moment. Next thing I want to show you, though, is the visitations. So with the visitations, you can actually click here to see who has visited and when, according to your records in PowerChurch. Or you can click to add a visitation, and it'll actually bring up the information that you will need. Now, again, I didn't save that default back in preferences, so this is set to none. But if I had set it to Jones P would have shown up there. So you can say who visited and when, what the purpose was. These are all fields that relate directly back to your PowerChurch data. And then click Add, and that will actually add the visit. So you can actually update your visit records while you're still visiting, is a very nice feature. Let's go back up to the top here and use the Navigate, and we'll go and look at some individual records. Individual records are very similar to the personal the family mailing list records, and just more information related to the individual, just like it is in PowerChurch. So now you'll have a work phone and a mobile phone instead of just a family phone number. You might have some additional email addresses if they have more than one. You're also seeing dates, so you can find out if today is their birthday or what have you. The other thing that you can see is down here in the activities section. So these are all the different activities that this person is a member of. So you can access the activities to see who else is in their group. We'll get to that in just a moment. Again, these are clickable buttons. You could actually click on these and dial the phone number, or go to the email client, and again it is editable. So let's take a look real quick at activities. We'll use our navigation here again. So here we have a list of all the activities that are in PowerChurch. So you can also see that there are several ways to sort these as well. You can do it by type or department, activity name or activity number. And depending on what you click, you'll get a slightly different screen. So these are the different types that you could have. So under here in Sunday school classes, you can see all the different Sunday school classes that we have. So let's click on one of these and actually go into it. The other thing that you'll see is, again, these are all the people that belong to that class. You'll also see what status they have in the class. So most of these people are members. As we get down to the bottom, if I wanted to contact the teacher of this class but I didn't know who it was, it's actually telling me here that this person is the teacher of the class. So this can work for a lot of different things. If you have different activities and skills, such as interest groups or committees, and you have different roles within those committees and interest groups, you can see what their roles are from here as well. So let's go back into Allen, and it basically just takes us back to the personal profile information where you can get contact info and dates and times and things of that nature. Okay, well let's take a look at these searches now. There are actually some powerful tools here in the searches. You can search two ways. You can search for contains whatever you're searching for or begins with. So if, for example, you can't remember whether it was Alan or Al, you could type Al in here and say, I know his first name begins with Al. So let's do a search for that. And then you get all the profiles that start with AL. So here's Alan. These are families. It's going to show you families first, and then it'll show you individual profiles. And as you can see, oops, I just clicked on that. As you can see, it's not just Alan Cunningham. It gives you everybody that begins with AL. Likewise, if we go back to the name search, we could do contains with, and we'll just use Al again. It doesn't matter the capitalization. So now I'm even getting more results because it's not just looking for the beginning of the name, it's actually looking for any name that has AL in it. So if you know a part of the name but not the whole name, you could search for it that way as well. So you can see that it gave us quite a few results. Okay, so those are the basics of the PowerChurch mobile web app. Again, this is designed to be used on smartphones and mobile devices. You can use this in a browser setting, but primarily this is designed to allow you access to your data away from your office. So this is something that we're really excited about. We're looking forward to getting feedback on it, and we're really excited that our customers are starting to use it. This we feel is a very powerful tool to add to the PowerChurch Online users. Thank you for watching.